polio still exists. For decades, we've been tirelessly working to eradicate this virus, and we've come incredibly close. Take a look at this graphic. Since 1988, we've eliminated over 99% of cases, thanks to organizations like Rotary. Now, only two countries still have cases of wild polio. So why should we care when the numbers are so low and isolated? Polio, or poliomyelitis, is a highly infectious viral disease that can affect the brain and spinal cord, causing paralysis. Children under 5 are at the highest risk, but anyone who is unvaccinated remains vulnerable. In the 1980s, hundreds of thousands were paralyzed by polio. Today, only a small number are. But polio isn't just about these paralytic cases. Less than 1% of those infected with polio develop paralysis, yet all cases are contagious. This means the virus can silently circulate, potentially leading to an outbreak. To eradicate polio, we need to track and monitor the virus through a process called surveillance. We flew to India to find answers in a country that in just recent history eliminated wild polio, to talk with Sunil Bahl at the World Health Organization.
Surveillance is defined as data collection for action. This is the eyes and ears of any public health initiative. It tells us where the virus is circulating, how many cases are happening, how is the disease spreading. And finally, it helps us to demonstrate that the disease is actually gone. Southeast Asia region was certified polio-free on 27th March 2014. However, the polio virus is still lurking around, and there is a risk of an importation.
Because polio anywhere is a risk everywhere, surveillance continues. Polio only infects humans and lives in human intestines and waste. So surveillance is conducted in two ways: indirect testing through wastewater and direct testing of individuals. Direct testing involves testing any child with acute flaccid paralysis, or AFP, which could be a sign of polio.
Yeah, I am here present, you know, to give us acute floppy paralysis case, then this is the case audio kit. He is being reported by St. Stephen's Hospital, Delhi, and I am looking for the house here.
There is an extensive system that has been put in place by the program.
Bahar mein kichhe, bahar mein kare. Okay, good.
In which every child who has acute flaccid paralysis is detected, reported, and investigated.
This is the AFP processing room wherein we receive the stool samples from acute flaccid paralysis patients. Get around 40 to 50 samples every day.
This local lab is one of 146 labs in 92 countries. Altogether, these labs test over 200,000 AFP samples a year to rule out polio. If polio is ever found, it undergoes genetic sequencing. Like all viruses, wild polio evolves. By tracing its genetic lineage, we can determine where it likely came from and the best response.
So there are three types of polio viruses. They have what we call as families. As we mount our immunization response, the expectation is that the families will go down. So there are type 1, type 2, and type 3. And each of these viruses is a disease in itself, and two of these diseases have been eradicated globally.
Two diseases are down, and the positive trends in our worldwide fight continue. In the past decade, the genetic diversity of polio type 1 has been steadily shrinking, bringing us closer to complete worldwide eradication.
I mean, there's no reason why it should not be eradicated, and I know it's going to happen. It's just a matter of time.